वेलकम टू दी 16th सेशन ऑफ इंट्रोडक्शन टू साइबर क्राइम. इन टूडेज सेशन वी विल स्टडी अ ग्लोबल परस्पेक्टिव ऑन साइबर क्राइम्स. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द ग्लोबल परस्पेक्टिव ऑन साइबर क्राइम. इन ऑस्ट्रेलिया दे क्रिएटेड द साइबर क्राइम एक्ट 2001 विच डिटेल्स ऑफेंसेस अगेंस्ट कंप्यूटर डेटा and systems. In the Council of Europe's, that is COE, cybercrime referred to an array of criminal activity including offenses against computer data and systems, computer related offenses, content offenses, and copyright offenses. The spam legislation scenario mentions nothing about India as far as email legislation in India is concerned. The legislation refers to India as a loose legislation, although there is a mention in section 67 of Indian ITA 2000. About 30 countries have enacted some form of anti-spam legislation. However, in spite of this, so far there has been no significant impact on the volume of spam, with spammers sending hundreds of millions of messages per day. Thus, one can see there is a lot to do toward building confidence and security in international cooperation agenda. The linkage of cyber security and critical infrastructure protection has become a big issue as a number of countries have begun assessment of threats, vulnerabilities, and started exploring mechanisms to reduce them. Recently, there have been a number of significant developments, such as the first one is in August 4, 2016 announcement, the US Convention on Cybercrime. The convention targets hackers, those spreading destructive computer viruses, those using the internet for the sexual exploitation of children, or the distribution of racist material, and terrorists attempting to attack infrastructure facilities or financial institution. Next one, in August 18, 2006, the European Union, that is EU, on website blocking. The European Union officials want to debar suspicious websites as part of plan to boost joint anti-terrorism activities. They want to block websites that include terrorist action. The third one, Cybercrime Convention, that is 1997 to 2001, was the first international treaty seeking to address internet crimes by harmonizing national laws, improving investigative techniques, and increasing cooperation among nations. More than 40 countries have ratified the convention to date. Next, we will study cyber crimes and the extended enterprise. If you see, average internet user, that is who doesn't know much about internet, but he is using the internet, that person don't understand about the threats and how to protect from that threats. Actually, it is the responsibility of every internet user to become aware of the threats as well as the opportunities that connectivity and mobility presents with them. The term extended enterprise represents the concept that a particular company is not just made up of its employee and its board member and executives, but also its business partners, its suppliers, and even its customers. The extended enterprise is only successful if all the component groups and individuals have the information they need in order to do business effectively. Seamless flow of information to support instant decision making ability is crucial for the external enterprise. This becomes possible through the interconnections. Due to the interconnected features of information and communication technologies, security overall can only be fully promoted when the users have full awareness of the existing threats and dangers. Governments, businesses, and the international community must therefore proactively help users access information on how to protect themselves. So that's it for today's session. So in today's session, we have studied a global perspective about cyber security.